Many iPhone users like to charge their device to 100%, likely since it's a satisfying number that ensures your device will last as long as possible. But it's not something you should do on a regular basis, and I'll explain why right now. So the type of batteries used in most modern electronics, including the iPhone, is lithium-ion, and its capacity is only good for a certain number of charges, or cycles, before it begins to degrade. You can actually check how much your battery has degraded right now by going to battery settings and tapping battery health. My iPhone 12 is at 95% of its full capacity, which means 5% of the battery cells have worn out from being charged and discharged over the last year. Obviously, we want to prevent our batteries from wearing out as much as possible, which is why charging all the way to 100% and allowing the battery level to drop down to 10% or less is considered bad practice. These deep discharges exhaust the lithium battery cells faster than charging to 80 or 90% and then getting it back on its charger by the time it reaches 30 or 40%. This not only ensures you get as much battery life out of your iPhone for as long as possible for those days when you really need it, but it also prevents performance issues caused by deeply degraded batteries. And Apple tries to alleviate this issue with software features like optimized battery charging, where the iPhone will wait to charge past 80% until it knows you're ready to use it based on your charging routine, so it won't sit at 100% for hours at a time. But if that does happen, you'll actually receive a notification that says your iPhone should be removed from power and discharged to improve battery health. But deep discharges also negatively affects the battery, which is where low power mode comes in. At 20%, your iPhone will automatically begin throttling performance and background tasks to prevent the battery from draining even further. And while that means more battery life for the user, it also means a higher likelihood that the device will be connected to power before reaching an extremely low battery percentage. So it's best to keep your battery level between 40 and 80% when possible, so on those busy days when you need every minute of battery life, your device will be there to deliver. This is Greg with Apple Explained. Thanks for watching till the end, and I'll see you in the next video.